A very good morning. It's Sunday the 25th of February and my name is Jeff Lawton. If you're new to the channel, then welcome. And if you have been here these few days that I've been putting information up, then hopefully you've made a few quid. We put a few up yesterday, I think three out of the four that I mentioned all won. So let's keep doing that. Now, I have said that if you want to contact me, excuse me, you can use my email, which is just below, and ask me anything. And also, if you want any to know when I'm going to have a big bet, then if you want to press the subscribe button, I will let you know as and when I'm going to do that. But I did get a few emails, and excuse me, people are asking me, what am I tipping, and can I reiterate what I'm tipping? Well, I need to say it's not a tipping service. It's more an educational thing. I'm trying to teach you how to find winners yourself without listening to people. And I want you to start to use figures. I know that's complicated for some people, but there are free ones. There are things like Racing Post ratings, which you can use. There are plenty of things like Time Form, Race Form. There are lots of things that you can use. And I think it's just important that you do start to use figures, because that will make a huge difference to your betting. I want you to stay away from the races that the bookies want you to bet in. Now, they will try and get you to bet in these complicated handicaps and offer you extra places and offer you enhanced odds and all this. It's nonsense. They're the races you will lose money in. Stay away from those. So there's only one meeting today, but I'm going to cover three races for you, and then you can make your own decisions. So we'll start in the 240. The horse I'm interested in is Kel de Large. Now, won a couple of bumpers on over a mile five and a mile six. Obviously, most bumpers are on over 2 miles, but they do have a few that are intermediate ones. And the second one, the mile six, that was on heavy ground at Cheltenham. And he certainly wasn't stopping over that trip on testing ground. Now, the ground won't be quite as testing today. And I think the 2 mile is definitely, it will not be a problem at all. Now, I know the plan with this horse after winning two bumpers was to go for the champion bumper in March. But they've had a change of heart and they've sent him hurdling from today. Now, I don't think the bar's set too high, and he's very highly regarded. If he can jump on the track like he's been doing at home, then I don't think he'll have a problem. I think they won't see which way he went. His main market rival also ran in that Cheltenham race where he was beaten 14 lengths. Now, he's since finished third in his only hurdle start, but Kel de Large has scored really well, and he should be winning this. So, 310, Mighty Moth. Now, she's run well in both her hurdles, chasing home the 139 rated Django Bay and the 134 rated Tell Her the Name, before finishing fifth in a listed race, not being that far, I think about 8 lengths, but they were the third, fourth and fifth were all very close up, and she was in that bunch. Now, this is a weaker contest. Although Venetia Williams paid €130,000 for Lady Presenter back in July. And now she ran six times in France without getting ahead in front. But she had some decent form to her name. Also, Largy Force won an Irish point to point, but there were plenty finished close up in that race. And it may not be great form. Now, without being a star, I think Mighty Moth should be better than these. The only other race that I want to look at is, if I can change my page, is the 410, and that is One Eye on Vegas. And now, he looked moderate until his last run, when they upped him to 2 mile four furlongs and also put cheek pieces on him. Now, he won readily that day from a horse called Lady Balco, who's gone on to win the next two races, and they were 17 lengths clear of the third. So given that she only went up £8 for that run, that looks more than reasonable, I think. She also loves testing ground. Owl of Athens could be interesting off a lowly mark of 90 on his handicap debut. But I think without saying I'm going to be back in one eye in Vegas, the other two I would be interested in backing. This one I'll watch at this stage, but I do think it's the most likely winner. So any questions? I'm going to be around a lot of the day today. So any questions, send me an email, jefflawtonmanagement@gmail.com. It's just below. And if you want any, when I'm going to go for a big bet, just subscribe to me and I'll do that. And I'll speak to you tomorrow. Thanks very much.